Today let us learn compound microscope. A simple microscope has a limited magnification, less than 10. For much larger magnifications, one uses two lenses. This is known as compound microscope. One lens is held close to the object. This is objective. Eye is positioned just near the other lens. This is eyepiece. The object AB is kept just beyond the focus of object A. It forms a real, inverted and magnified image A1, B1. This image acts as the object for eyepiece. The tube length is adjusted such that the image A1, B1 lies within the focus of the eyepiece. If the object lies between the optical center and the focus of a lens, the image will be virtual or the refracted rays are diverging. And the position of the object is adjusted such that the final image is formed at the near point. The final image A2, B2 is formed at the near point. The near point distance we can denote it as D. And now let us find the magnifying power. The magnifying power is the total linear magnification. For two lenses, the total magnification is the product of the linear magnifications. MO is the magnification of object A and ME is the magnification of eyepiece. MO, linear magnification, is V by U. The image A1, B1 lies very close to eyepiece, so the image distance is approximately equal to tube length. And the object of the objective is just beyond the focus, so the object distance is approximately equal to focal length. So MO approximately equal to L by FO. The eye lens acts as a simple microscope, so its magnification ME is equal to V by U is equal to 1 minus V by F, and since the image is at the near point, this is equal to 1 plus D by FE, where D is the near point or 25 centimeter. Therefore, the total magnifying power M is equal to L by FO into 1 plus D by FE. As the focal length of objective and eyepiece decreases, the magnifying power increases. So for the construction of a compound microscope, the two lenses should be of small focal length to have larger magnifying power. The objective should be of small aperture as the object is a minute object. Eyepiece, the aperture is larger than that of the objective. If the final image is formed at infinity, then we can observe the image with a relaxed eyes. For that, we should adjust the tube length in such a way that the first image A1, B1 lies at the focus of eyepiece. The refracted rays are parallel, so the final image is at infinity. In this case, the magnifying power is the product of magnifications MO into ME. As in the previous case, MO is equal to L by FO. But in the case of eyepiece, M is equal to D by FE. Therefore, M is equal to L by FO into D by FE. So magnifying power is inversely proportional to focal length of objective and eyepiece. Thank you.